This has always been my room, and you two are the newcomers. You are going to have to fit in with me. Do you understand?
Yeah, sure, B. We understand.
Bloody interfering screws always changing things around. Well, that's the way they want it. That's the way they can damn well have it. They can run this place themselves. I've had it.
Frightened the living daylights out of me.
I'm sorry. Why did you keep running through the front door like that?
Oh, they're everywhere.
Now, come on, calm down and tell me what's wrong.
Somebody's out to get me.
What?
They tried to come through the back door.
A prowler?
Yeah. Phone keeps ringing. There's nobody there.
Now, wait a minute. One thing at a time.
All the plants keep moving. Put them in one place and I can't even turn me back. Somebody shifted them.
Lizzie, are you sure you're not imagining things?
No worries. Saw the doorknob turn with my own eyes.
All right, then. We'll go round and have a look.
What in the dark?
We can't wait till daylight, can we? Oh, come on. Are you going to come with me or not?
Oh, I'm scared.
All right, then. We'll call the police.
Oh, no. I don't want the wallopers near my house.
You don't want the police and you won't go round the back? How else are we going to find out if you've got a prowler?
Well,
come on. We'll be safe together.
Lizzie, you're making me nervous now.
Oh, shh. I will not shoot you. If there's someone here, we've got to flush them out.
Well, I reckon there's more than one of them.
Well, where are they, then?
You say you thought the doorknob turned.
I didn't think it turned. I saw the bloody thing turn.
I tell you, I heard a noise like scraping, like somebody was using a jemmy or something.
It must be a pretty soft jemmy.
But I heard.
Lizzie, there are no marks. If somebody'd used a jimmy on the door, there'd be marks here.
Oh, I tell you, somebody's trying to get at me.
Well, there's your prowler, Lizzie, the local tomcat.
I suppose you think I've been making everything up.
No, I didn't say that. But this isn't Wentworth. I mean, you're used to having people around you all the time.
So?
Well, it's a bit different in the suburbs. Can be a bit scary when you're not used to it.
I suppose I have to get used to that phone ringing, nobody answering it.
Well, perhaps it's just a 40 line. Oh. Well, I mean, I sometimes hear the phone ringing, and it's my neighbour's, not mine.
Do you reckon I don't know when it's my own phone ringing? I haven't been in Clink that long.
Well, we'll get on to telecom in the morning. Ask them to make a check on it.
And what about that plant? I suppose you don't believe that that was moving around.
Oh, really, Lizzie? Next thing you'll have the house hopping around.
Come on, let's go back inside.
Want a coffee?
Ugh, my bloody mattress has gone lumpy.
Do you want a coffee?
I mean, I've got enough problems to keep me awake without this one. My bed is right under the place where Linda was hanging. Spooky. Feels like she's still there. Screws just move you around. They don't care where you sleep. I mean, you wouldn't catch one of them sleeping here.
Will you shut up about it, Doreen? For crying out loud, I'm the one that had to find her hanging here. I can still see that girl's face in my head.
Yeah, well, I just think the screws should have found her somewhere else to sleep.
Oh, well, that's terrific, that is. You're the one that asked for a transfer in here. What's that about?
Yeah, well, I didn't have much choice, did I? It's not the same with Bea anymore. She doesn't care about her mates laughing and joking with that Sandy Tart after what she did to us.
Stop whinging, Doreen. At least we're alive. Poor kid would be alive too, wouldn't she, if it wasn't for Mrs. Morris?
Yeah. You could see Linda needed help. You're real smart like that, Jude.
Well, obvious, wasn't it? Any fool could have seen she was out of her tree.
What I mean is, well, we're going to need your brains. We can't trust Bea anymore.
Forget it, Doreen. How many times do I have to tell you I am not interested in being top dog?
Yeah, well, Bea's so busy sucking up to the screws and getting braille machines to play with.
Good for her.
She's going to let that Sandra walk all over us.
Well, I can look after myself.
Yeah? And what happens if she finds out about your pacemaker, like Margot did?
Shut up, Doreen. You wake Lizzie up.
It's me, B. Kate.
What do you think you're doing? Aren't you leaving other people to sleep?
I'm sorry. I was just getting a drink. I was thirsty.
Yeah, well, why don't you drink and then get back to bed?
Might as well have a cup of myself now I'm awake. Sorry, love, I think I just broke your jug.
Oh, that's terrific. You have any idea how hard those things are to get?
It was only an accident.
Well, I don't give a bugger what it was. You have any idea how much trouble it is to get one of those? You shouldn't have. That's what I'm saying. You shouldn't have. This is my bloody cell. Why can't you be careful?
Takes over Bea's job, well, I reckon there's going to be fights all over this place. And I mean, this will be nothing to what'll happen if we don't stop her.
So we let someone else do the fighting, huh?
Yeah, and then they'll jump us in the dark. You know what happened with Margot, and sooner or later, the screw's going to find out what's going on, and we'll lose our privileges.
I know that, Dor, but let's let someone else take care of it, okay?
Well, I'd do it myself, Jude, but you're the only one who's got the brains for it.
Now that might not be right, you know. We don't know that Bea's quit, do we?
Yeah, well, half the time she's off with that bloody braille machine of hers, and then when she is around, she's no bloody help.
Yeah, well, she has been different, I'll give you that.
Well, will you do it?
I'll admit something has to be done.
Yeah, we'll all support you.
Look, not so fast, Dor. I've got to talk to Bea first.
Well, she can't have it both ways. If she's not going to do the job, she's got to let you take over, don't you reckon?
An old woman like me shouldn't have to put up with things like that.
Come on, why don't you pull the tea, why don't you tell me?
Oh, yeah. The first time the phone rang, I was making a cup of coffee.
The tea, Lizzie. Let's drink it before it gets cold.
Oh, sorry, Mrs. M. All this scary stuff's making me a bit absent-minded.
Thanks.
Then the phone rang again. I said, hello. But there was nobody there. But I knew there was somebody there, because you can feel them, you know?
Well?
A bit later, the phone rang again. But they hung up on me, so I knew there was somebody there. Then I could feel somebody watching me from outside. You know, oh, that's me cooking, Sherry, Mrs. M.
Mm-hmm.
I've hardly touched a drop since I come home, honest.
Well, you're certainly a lot calmer than when I first arrived, so I think I'd better be going.
Oh, yeah. Here's me gassing away, forgetting you got a home of your own to go to.
Mm.
I suppose it's just that I was frightened of being left on my own, you know?
I'm sure you'll be all right now. I've jotted down the police phone number just in case you need them.
Oh, thank you for dropping by, Mrs. M. I reckon I would still be running if you hadn't come.
Why don't you go to bed, get a good night's sleep?
Yeah, I think I will. I'll see you to the front door.
No, 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 I'll go out the back way. Just make sure all the bogeymen have gone.
Oh, thank you, Mrs. M. You are a good sport.
Good night.
Good night.
YMCA. Yesterday's muck cooked again.
Yeah, well, I don't mind it for a change. I could go seconds.
Well, you're welcome to mine if your stomach's that strong.
Bit picky, aren't you? She's not going to be any good to anybody if she doesn't eat. Well, what's wrong with you now?
Look, I've got to talk to someone.
Sudden, the air over there didn't smell so good. You know what I mean?
Well, what's the matter, Dawn? Didn't you sleep well last night?
Bloody smart, Alec.
I've got work to do and I'm in no mood for a chat.
Well, this has to be sorted out now.
I want to go to the library now. Get out of my way.
B, if you want to be boss, that's fine by all of us, but if you don't, I wish you'd say something.
I will say what I like when I like.
Listen, that's all very well for you, isn't it?
Listen, I'm tired of you running to me with your problems all the time.
Well, that can change. You just say the word.
The only word I'm saying to you is get out of my way.
Do you want to be top dog or not?
I'm nobody's dog. Now, I want to go to the library. Do I have to walk over your water to get there? Because I will if I have to.
All I'm saying is when the boss coffee goes loopy, the whole place falls apart.
What?
If B. Smith's losing her marbles, this block will be a madhouse in a couple of days. You watch.
Oh, you're exaggerating. The Warders would never allow that.
I've seen it, kiddo. I've lived through it. You wouldn't believe what goes on when the screws aren't looking. Murders, riots, the works. So far, it's been kids' play. That's why I need your help. So I can cool the place down.
So you're after B. Smith's job?
No. Not unless I have to. All I want is a comfortable stay in this place, but that's not going to happen unless there's top dog. So we've got to get our own.
What are you two standing around for?
Hey, just a minute, Edwards. I asked you a question. Now, look, you're going to be in this place quite a long time, so you'd better learn the rules now. Do you hear me?
Yes, sir. Ma'am.
Well, just to make you learn the rules faster, you can both scrub floors for an hour after work this afternoon. Now get going. So, the top dog runs the prison. Seems to me they do.
You'll learn.
Abby, still plugging away at it?
Yeah, I'm getting there.
Dropped in to see Lizzie yesterday.
Yeah.
Almost had to stay the night.
Getting a bit lonely, eh?
Oh, she's having prowlers, mystery phone calls, the lot. Mind you, they all disappeared as soon as I arrived.
Mm.
Wish I could make it easier for her to settle in. Have you any ideas?
Well, she'll be okay when she makes a few more friends.
Yes, but she looks up to you. Perhaps she'd listen to your suggestions.
Well, I've spent enough of my life telling other people what to do. She's on her own.
You're all right, B. You don't seem yourself.
Well, how the hell should I know? Look, if the women want to jump up and down and squabble and fight, that's their lookout. I don't give a damn if they knock each other's blocks off.
And what brought this on?
The women want me to do one thing. The screws want me to do another thing. I'm getting pushed and shoved all over the place.
Sorry.
And they all come to Queen Bee with their problems. Well, to hell with everyone. I'm tired. I'm sick and bloody tired. If you want to know what's going on, ask Judy. I'm busy.
All right. I'll come back when you're feeling better.
You'll have to excuse the mess. I've just been washing up.
Don't worry about me. I just dropped in to see if you were settling in all right.
That's very nice of you. I'm getting along fine.
Finding the house comfortable?
Couldn't be better. I don't suppose you'd like a cuppa.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind.
Had a spooky old time of it last night.
Oh, really? What happened?
There was this person kept ringing me up. It wouldn't speak. Just kept silent.
Well, I wouldn't let that frighten you. Probably just some children playing a joke.
There was somebody prowling about, too.
Really? Did you see who it was?
No, but I could hear him. And I could feel him.
Don't suppose it was windy last night?
Put the wind up me, I can tell you.
I can imagine.
I don't suppose it was the wind that turned the doorknob. I heard the doorknob turn. Don't suppose you believe me, Mrs. Morris wouldn't.
Oh, I don't know about that. I used to live in this house, don't forget. When I was a child, I used to imagine crocodiles under the bed and ghosts up the chimney.
Well, I'm not exactly a kid.
I must admit, by daylight, they'd all disappeared.
Oh, I've got the teaspoons. I'm losing my memory.
Oh, look, Lizzie, it's later than I thought. I'd better give the tea a miss. I've really got to be going.
Okay.
Look, I hope you don't have any more little problems.
I'll be all right.
Good. Bye for now, then.
Oh, bugger it. Nothing works around this place.
Keep out of door. You'll have it sewn up in no time. I have a word with you, please, Judy.
Well, if I don't want to talk to you.
What's the matter with everyone today?
First,
the last time I talked to you, you told me to mind my own business, remember?
For heaven's sake, Judy, this is to help all of you.
People can die from your kind of help, Mrs. Morris.
I don't know what I'm supposed to have done, but this isn't the time or the place to talk about it.
Good. Well, you won't mind if I get back to work then, will you?
Good day, Mr. Powell.
Oh, Mr. Humphrey. What brings you round here?
Just making sure your new neighbour's settled in all right.
And she is, I trust.
Well, I'm not so sure. That's why I wanted to talk to you. As a matter of fact, she's been acting a bit strangely.
Well, she isn't exactly your average old lady.
Oh, that's for sure. Now, she's been telling me stories about prowlers and noises and strange phone calls.
Round here? Oh, this neighbourhood is so quiet, it's boring.
Yeah. Yeah, that's my impression. Look, I know it's none of your business, but I'm a bit worried about the old dear.
Oh, I don't know. If the truth's known, she's probably just a bit senile.
You think so?
Well, between you and me, she should never have been released from Wentworth.
Is that right?
Come on, you lot, I'm running out of things to press.
Oh, you rotten mongrel!
Naughty, naughty. What would Mother Teresa say?
Do you reckon you're a bit snaky with Mrs. Morris before?
No, I don't, Dora. We pay for our crimes, she should pay for hers. That kid would still be alive if it wasn't for her.
Yeah, I suppose so. Hey, what are we going to do about her?
In the rec room after lunch.
What's that? I can't hear, girls. You'll have to speak up. We better keep our eyes open. Laurel and Hardy are talking behind our backs. Oh, that's it for me. Let's eat.
Service faults? Yes. Yes, well, we think we're having nuisance phone calls. Well, nobody talks when we answer the phone. Okay.
It's 3500631. Good. Thank you very much. Well, they're going to look into it. Now, tell me slowly, Lizzie. What happened?
This photo of Sid. It was in the drawer with the knives and forks.
Hmm? Well, what's the problem?
I didn't put it there, and I've never seen that photo before.
But Sid used to live here, for goodness sake. There are bound to be lots of photos of him around that you haven't seen.
I've been to that drawer 6 times today.
And the photo wasn't there till the 7th time. Is that what you're telling me?
That's what I'm trying to tell you.
Well, what can I say, Lizzie?
Well, you've got to believe me, otherwise I reckon I'm going crackers.
Look, I'd love to, but... Well, tell me, what about the telly?
Well... Put it on, and it went straight off again.
Well, any set will do that if it's blown a fuse.
Oh, I don't understand those things.
Lizzie, are you missing your friends in Wentworth?
Of course I'm missing them. But I don't want to go back there. I love Sid's house. I said I'm going to make a life for myself here. And I'm going to...
Good. I'm glad to hear it. Come on, let's see what's wrong with the telly, eh? See? A blown fuse, just as I thought. Now, if we fix that, I bet your telly works again.
But I had the telly on before. Why would it fuse this time?
Look, Lizzie, the fuse, the phone, the noises, they're all separate. But your mind's putting them together. Your mind's just playing tricks on you.
Oh, I wish you'd believe me, Mrs. M. Somebody's trying to scare me. And they're making a bloody good job of it, too.
You sit this one out, okay?
We don't like newcomers being pushy, Edwards.
So?
So we've come to teach you a little lesson.
Too gutless to talk without your heavies, Bryant.
Well, if talking doesn't work, maybe muscle will.
I see a lot of fat, not much muscle.
Oh, shut up, bucket mouth. Come on, let's get her.
Talk about it first, but heaven's sake.
Bag her off.
Stay out of it, Kate. It'll only be a minute with this
one
anyway.
Come on, Drew, let's get her.
Come on, stop it. Stop it, you kill her. Doreen, I'm surprised at you. All right, who started it and what's it all about?
Well, I think you were all involved. But I'll only report the two I saw. Now, that's you, Bryant, and you, Edwards. Bryant, you get to your cell and stay there. And you too, Burns.
Another couple of minutes, we would have fixed up here. How'd you like that, eh?
Get a move on.
Edwards Peterson, up against that wall.
See, they're not so tough.
Now, you others clear up that mess. And I don't want anyone leaving until I get back.
You did all right for yourself. Next time, stay out of the way. You might get hurt.
You two get to your cell and wait for me there. Now, I want everything back the way it was, understand?
I'll have trouble getting that telly back the way it was.
Miss Conway. That little scrap was quite normal, you know. I wouldn't worry about it too much.
Yeah, well, someone might have been hurt.
But they weren't.
Well, it was lucky I came along when I did. Now, what started it?
Well, it all goes back to Linda hanging herself, I guess.
But why?
Look, they're just fighting to let off steam. Linda's death scared the hell out of all of us.
Yeah, well, I can't ignore a fight like that.
Why not? If you report them, they'll just get to solitary, and when they come out, they'll be wound up twice as much as they are now. And they'll be after you as well as each other. When you've been here a bit longer, you'll learn to judge what's serious and what isn't.
Well...
Being shoved behind bars can really shake your nerves up a bit. But you'd remember that, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Were you scared?
Of course I was.
Well, you were only here a couple of weeks. Imagine what it would be like if you'd been in here for years. One day you walk into your cell and there's your roommate hanging by her neck. You see what I mean? Listen, let's go into the library and talk about it privately.
So stupid, like kids. Kicking and bashing just to see who's toughest.
There's no debating society in here, kiddo. Straight A's don't matter a damn when you get your head punched in.
I'll defend myself if I have to, but you go looking for fights.
Hey, hang on. I was just sitting down minding my own business, remember?
All right, but why fight? We talked about our problems. We've achieved far more.
That's all very well for your local mother's club. This is a prison.
So?
Prisons are for bad girls, and bad girls don't talk, they kick.
How can you be so sure talking won't work? You tried?
Wouldn't waste my time.
Anyway, I just don't see how I can drop the charge. Too many people know about it already and they're going to talk.
Hang on. You leave that to me. You'd be surprised what people can forget when I ask them to.
Yeah, well, what about the television?
I'm coming to that. Look, that television set was probably the only casualty in the fight, right? Well, it already had the gong anyway, so how about you persuade Conway Discounts to come to the party with a new one?
Well, what about the old one?
Oh, you'd say they dropped it or something. I don't know. I'll figure that out later. So what are you going to do?
No, look, it's too risky. I've got to report it.
Now, listen.
And I don't like you telling me what to do.
How would you like being called a jailbird by everyone on this block? It is up to you, of course.
Well, I don't know about the report, but I will see what I can do about the television.
Yeah?
Well, my brother keeps offering them to me. I've never taken one.
Hmm.
Look, all right, I'll ask him.
Make it a nice colour one. They'd enjoy that.
Well, I suppose it's a tax deduction for him.
Thanks, Kate. I'll make sure they appreciate it.
What are you doing here, Burns? I thought I told you to get back to your cell.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry, Miss.
Yeah, well, hurry up.
Oh, listen,
What is it?
Well, I know you're real mad at me about the fight and everything.
Of course I am.
Well, I just wanted to thank you again for them art books, you know. I've had a real good look at them and they're terrific.
Is that all?
Yeah.
Well, I've got a lot more important things to do, Doreen.
God! I just saw Conway and she nearly took my head off. You and her got something going, have you?
What's it to you?
Joint's going crazy. You and me used to be the best of mates and now I haven't even got a clue what you're thinking. Will you let that fight go on without lifting a finger? We don't even know who you're barracking for. You want some chocolate? It's nuts and raisins.
Doreen, you've got eyes. I'm busy.
Well, you've got time for Conway, haven't you? Why haven't you got time for your mates?
Get lost.
Well, what's she got that we haven't?
Dory, will you mind your own business?
Right, I will.
Dory!
Oh, hi. Why you sit down the mouth?
Oh, a couple of women dropped the television when they were shifting it, and a fight broke out. I don't know. I didn't handle it very well. I guess I need a coffee.
Here, let me take care of that. You sit down. Take the weight off your feet. What'd you like? Black, white, with or without?
Black. Thank you. I would have thought you'd have had coffee taken up to your office.
Yeah, well, I could, I suppose, but... Well, it gets a bit lonely in there. This place is a lot friendlier. There you go. Now, why the frown?
Well, I guess it's just the strain of the job.
Well, look at me. Do I look strained?
No.
Well, I've got much the same sort of job as you, so what's your excuse?
Well, I feel that I've got to be on my guard all the time. If I let it down, something terrible is going to happen.
Well, I'm afraid there's no way around that. We're paid to be on guard. Look, what you've got to learn to do is just to be able to go home at night and forget all about Wentworth. Relax. Enjoy yourself.
Yeah, I guess you're right. You know, I go home and I have nightmares about Wentworth.
Now, what you need is somebody to teach you how to have a good time. Yeah. Now, fortunately, I know just the person. Me.
Yeah, but what about the department? I mean, you are the governor.
I am the acting governor.
And I happen to be a junior officer.
What we do outside this place is nobody's business but our own.
All right. Why not?
Good. Well, listen, I ran across this rather nice little pub the other day. Good restaurant. What say we go there tonight?
Sounds lovely.
Right. It's a date. Good. Thanks, Officer Barfield. Come in, Smith. How are you? Look, apparently the women are getting a bit restless. Do you know anything about it?
Well, I haven't noticed anything out of the ordinary, but then how could I? I've been in the library most of the time.
Well, my officers told me that there's something going on. I thought you might know what it was.
Well, did they also tell you what it was?
Well, if I knew that, I wouldn't be asking you, would I?
Well, Linda Goldman hanging herself didn't exactly cheer everyone up, I can tell you that much.
No, I'm sure it didn't. But there's more to it than that. Now, if I know what it is, maybe I can stop somebody getting hurt.
Well, you want it straight? Anytime you start moving prisoners around without asking them, you are in for trouble.
What do you mean?
Do you care that I have been here for years? Do you care that I don't like new prisoners just being shoved into my cell?
This is a prison, Smith. It's not a guest house.
Well, if you want your prison to run smoothly, I suggest you learn to negotiate.
I don't like your tone, Smith. I give the orders around here.
Well, only until Mrs. Davidson gets back. And then you take orders just like anybody else?
Just watch your tongue, Smith. You're forgetting which side of the bars you're on.
Look, if you want to know what's going on, ask Judy.
What?
I don't want to have anything to do with a whole rotten mess.
Seems to me the Queen Bee's getting a bit old and tired.
Queen Bee? Now, how could I possibly be that? Haven't you just got through telling me that you give the orders?
Thank you, Officer Barfield. Take her back to where you found her.
Oh, thank Christ for that.
Oh, keep still, Jude. Every time you wriggle, I end up making your nose fatter.
Don't do that, mate. It's the thinnest thing I got.
Mm. You know, I never noticed your mouth being like that before.
My mouth?
You moved again, Jude.
Oh, sorry, Dora. Hey, listen, Dora.
Hmm?
What do you make of Conway? Why don't you give you all those books?
Don't know. Maybe she's just trying to help.
She's a funny one, isn't she? What do you think of her?
Oh, who cares? Just as long as she keeps giving with the goodies.
You reckon she's trying to get you on side?
Don't know. Still reckon there's something going on between her and Bea, I can tell you that much.
What makes you say that?
Well, heard her talking to Bea in the library. When Conway came out, you should have seen her face.
Oh, hello, Miss Conway.
Oh, hi. And just what did you hear outside the library, Doreen?
Well, I didn't really hear anything. It's just a rumour that's gone round, that's all.
And what's the rumour?
Oh, just something about you and Bea.
What sort of something?
It's just what the women were saying, that's all.
Doreen, what is it?
Well, just that it seems as though you and Bea know each other from somewhere else.
Nothing else?
No, I told you it wasn't much. You know, it gets real boring in here and we have to make a big deal out of something.
All right. Bryant, the governor wants to see you in his office.
Oh. Sorry, kid. The nose goes with me.
Yes. Ah, thanks, Officer Conway. Come in, Brian. You may as well stay, Officer Conway. We won't be long.
Yes, sir.
All right, Brian. What do you know about the unrest amongst the women?
What unrest?
Oh, come on, Brian. You can do better than that.
Well, I don't know what you're talking about. How about giving me a clue, huh?
All right, we'll start with the fight in the rec room.
Oh, is that all? It's just that Linda's suicide freaked everybody out, you know?
I know that, but it's more than that.
Well, personally, I don't need it to be more than that. I'm the one that's sleeping in the room where it happened. How would you like that?
Who's top dog at the moment, Brian?
Bea is, of course, always has been.
There's nobody trying to knock her off a perch?
I'd like to see that happen.
All right, Brian, that'll be all.
Hey, Mr. Fletcher, could you transfer me out of that cell?
We'll talk about it some other time. Wait outside. You have to keep asking these questions, even though you know you're not going to get anywhere.
Yeah, well, it must be frustrating.
Yeah, it is, but you have to keep sticking to it. Now, will I pick you up at your place tonight?
Yeah, that'd be fine.
Good. It's a date. Take her to the dining room, will you?
G'day, Bea. How's your braille machine?
It's okay. Any more flack after the fight?
What would you care?
Oh, no, come on, Doreen. I did do some work behind the scenes, you know.
Oh, you did you?
Yes, I did. Now, are you going to answer my question?
Well, we're not sure yet. Just a few nosy questions from Fletch, you know.
Hey, Bea, the telly's a real write-off. What are we going to do about that?
Oh, I wouldn't worry about that. It's all been taken care of.
What do you mean? We're getting a newie.
Spare chance.
Oh, that's great.
Tell you what, she's still got style. Wish I'd known her when she was on top.
So now maybe you can all stop your whinging.
Yeah.
Why all the smiles? Christmas come early.
Ho, ho, ho.
You should hear what Bea's just done for us.
Hey, don't go spraying it around.
We're getting a new telly.
You're kidding. How come?
Bea didn't say.
Isn't it terrific? Is it going to be a colour one, Bea?
Well, you never know your luck.
Well, I'd like to know where it's coming from.
Here you are. One whiskey sour.
You know, I thought of a lot of things for us to talk about. I can't remember one of them.
Well, why don't we just relax and talk about ourselves, shall we? To us. Well, tell me all about yourself. Well, where you were born, who your parents were, and your pet kitten's name.
Had an average childhood, average education, and I led an average life.
Oh, I don't believe you. No one that looks like you is average in any way at all.
Is that a compliment?
It certainly is.
Thank you.
You're not enjoying that, are you?
Well, I'm afraid I am a simple drinker.
Say no more. What would you like?
I'd like a brown cow, thank you.
A brown cow? And you're a simple drinker?
Look, Sandy Edwards has only been here a couple of minutes, and already she's trying to take over. I reckon between us, we've spent 20 years in this same block. Are we going to sit by and let that happen?
No way. She might start taking our buy-ups like Margot did.
That's right. And three guesses who'd be running the book then.
She's pretty tough, Bud. How are we going to stop her?
I got it all worked out. And if it goes well, no one will get hurt.
How?
We play the numbers game. We get so many women on our side, she's going to have to back down.
Where from?
We'll be supporters. We'll get them all behind me.
Yeah, but what about your pacemaker, Jude? They haven't forgotten what happened with Margot.
Yeah, but we'll have to make sure that she doesn't find out, right?
Yeah, well, let's leave Bea out of this, too.
We'll only use her name. Look, once the women see that Sandy's back down, we'll be running the whole show.
Yeah, well, if you really think we can do it.
Of course we can do it, Dor. We know the numbers game. We know how it works. Let's use it on her, right?
I put all my things away. I hope you noticed. I'm sure if we all compromise a bit, we could make each other more comfortable. Don't you agree?
Terrific. You compromise. I'll be comfortable.
You saw the fight in the recreation room?
I've seen lots of fights.
The women were talking about your not joining in.
Well, they talk about do join in, they talk about don't join in. Who gives a damn anyway?
They seem to think there might be something wrong. Maybe you were a bit off colour.
Rack off! If I want a quack, I will find my bloody own.
Well, I couldn't help noticing you seem to have a headache.
I'll give you a headache, you lagger.
I didn't report anyone, if that's what you mean. I went to the warders about Linda because I thought she needed psychiatric help. Well, I was right, wasn't I?
Oh, yes, you were right. But why didn't you come to me or the other women first?
Because I'm a doctor and people's illnesses are confidential.
Are a doctor? Or was a doctor? This is a prison you're living in, remember?
Yes, I know.
Yeah, well, you don't act like it.
I can adjust.
Oh, well, fancy that. I wish you'd hurry up and start. Because you are giving me the irrits.
Morning. Finally going to be out and about.
All right, I'll have to say that around here.
What have you got for us?
Colour telly. Where do you want me to put it?
Well, I don't know. I didn't know we were getting one.
Hmm?
Sure you got the right place.
Well, there can't be two Wentworth detention centres.
No.
Morning, Wendy.
Morning, Judy.
Hello there.
Yeah, love house chicks.
Oh, okay.
Maybe you know where this telly's supposed to go.
Well, if it's the one for the rec room, that sure was quick delivery.
Well, we like to keep our customers happy, you know.
Oh, could I see the thing?
Sure can. There you go.
Well, that's the one. All the way from Conway Discounts. Oh, Miss Barfield, this is the telly for the rec room. This good chap's going to put it in for us, right?
Well, I don't know about the good, but I'll go along with the rest of it. See you, mate.
I don't see you in here very often, Bee. Anything wrong?
I've got a headache, sister. And it's really getting to me.
Well, tell me more about it.
Well, what more is it to tell?
Well, where's the pain?
No, sometimes it's all over. Sometimes it's down here. Sometimes it's behind my eyes.
Mm. Any other symptoms?
I'm not feeling the best. I'm all right, though. I just need a few aspirin.
Well, I don't know about a few. Well, how long's it been going on?
A while, I guess. Look, the regular two tablets just aren't going to touch this one.
Just how many do you think it'll take?
About half a dozen.
You're not thinking of trading them, are you, Bee?
Oh, come on. If you could feel inside my head, you wouldn't ask such a stupid question.
Well, I can't give you more than two. I'm sorry, Bee, but they're the rules.
Half a dozen lousy aspirin. That's all I'm asking for.
Come back in 4 hours if it's still bothering you. And if it is, I'll arrange for you to see the doctor.
Thanks a million.
Hey, Bee, you seen the new telly?
Well, is it here already?
Yeah, all they gotta do is connect it.
Well, how about that?
Why do you say that? Weren't you expecting it so soon?
Not quite. I'm not complaining.
You sure know how to get express delivery, Bee?
Yeah, the way I got it figured, you must have scared the hell out of someone.
Yeah, I don't care what you've got figured.
Oh, well, I heard that Conway's give good discounts, didn't you, Jude?
What are you talking about? By the look of her, I reckon she'd charge double.
Yeah.
All right, you two, knock it off.
Isn't it funny? We got a telly just like that out of the blue.
Yeah, I reckon we must be on their favourite charity list.
How I got that TV is my business. Now, if you want it, you'll shut up about it. But if you don't, it can always go back where it came from. Now, if you excuse me, I've got some work to do.
What the hell are you doing in here?
I was looking for you.
Pinching stuff, more like it.
I don't do things like that.
Oh, yeah? Well, you could have seen from the door whether we were in here or not.
I wish you'd believe me. I just came to talk to you.
What about?
Well, nothing in particular.
So you're poking around in our room just to chat about the weather, eh?
Well, I just wanted to avoid a fight like yesterday's.
Mm-hmm. Somebody send you?
No.
Now, you listen to me. You better watch your step, Doc. Or you're liable to end up biting off more than you can chew.
I've got no quarrel with you two. In fact, we hardly know each other, so why fight? I mean, I've always been against fighting. It seems so unnecessary to hurt each other.
Really? I thought you were in for murder.
Well, I can explain about that.
What the hell do you reckon you're pushing around?
Oh, oh, yeah. Hey,
get up against the wall.
Stand up.
Oh, yeah.
You don't look too good, Kate. Maybe you should see a doctor or something.
Let's eat.
Yeah. Kate!
Who got you, Brian? Anyone with her?
Yes.
Fat duck Dory.
I think the other one was called Hazel.
Do you believe me now? Do you understand about those slobs? Don't worry. We'll pay him back. But no more talking, okay? I told you before, they only understand one thing. So, are you with me or not?
Yes. You can count me in.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around.